'Cause I'm missing you, I'm still alright to smile. Girl, I think about you every day now. Was a time when I wasn't sure, but you set my mind at ease. There is no doubt you're in my heart now. Said woman, take it slow, it'll work itself out fine. All we need is just a little patience. Said sugar, make it slow, and we'll come together fine. All we need is just a little patience.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this Sunday morning, the 28th of August, the last Sunday of this month, a beautiful Sunday. It's even more beautiful because you're here and you've joined us here today to this online service where we come together as a community of faith in this digital forum as Sunshine Salvos and worship our Lord online. You've been very patient with me this morning. And would you believe that's the theme of what we're going to be looking at in our worship time today. It's really a bit of a hidden treasure, a hidden lesson within the story of Esther, which reminds us of the beauty of patience. And yes, you have been very patient with me in the start of this worship service. Thank you for joining us here today. Been a wonderful week we've had at Sunshine Salvos. I'm going to talk a little more in the announcements just about some things to do with Sunshine Salvos, but we come here to worship. And that's really the focus and should be the number one reason why you have made that choice to click on the play button this morning and engage with God in and through this online service at Sunshine Salvos. Welcome again. Of course, we come and we gather on lands that are traditional lands. I want to pay my respects to the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation, and I honour their ancestors of the past, those leaders here in the present, and also honour the aspiration of future First Nations leaders in this great Southland of Australia. I also state again the commitment of the Salvation Army Australia Territory to the process of reconciliation and achieving justice for First Nations people. We gather on lands no matter where we are here in Australia. These lands were never ceded. They were, they are, and always will remain Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander lands. We commence with a call to worship prayer. And I invite you to join with me as we commence this worship time together this day. Eternal Spirit, eternal God, living Lord, in whom we live and move and have our being. All that we are, all that we have been, and all shall be known to you, to the very secrets of our hearts, and all that rises within to trouble us. Living flame burn into us. Cleansing wind this day blow through us. Fountain of water well up within us, that we may love and praise in deed and in truth. We worship you this day, Spirit of God, and we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. I don't know about you, but I've got a lot of reasons every morning that I wake up to be joyful. I'm joyful simply for the fact that I woke up. One of the greatest miracles of all creation happens every morning when we wake out of our sleep and our bodies activate again for a new day. So I'm joyful today for that simple fact. I'm joyful that we had a wonderful day yesterday fundraising out at Bunnings. I'll talk about that a little later. I'm joyful for many things, but I'm joyful most of all that I'm here to worship God as his creation, as his child. Joyful, joyful, we adore you, Lord, God of glory, Lord of love, and we worship you this day. We're going to sing of that wonderful joy that really abounds in our hearts and spills out in and through our life. Joyful, joyful, we adore you, Lord, this day. Would you sing with me this day?
Sun above, mouth of fill us with the light of day. All thy works with joy surround thee, earth and heaven reflect thy rays, stars and angels sing around thee, center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, failing mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, call us to rejoice in thee. Mortals, join the happy chorus which the morning stars begin. Men to men, ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music leads us onward in the triumph.
And we move into a time of prayer, acknowledging again the prayer issues that are contained within this prayer video that really are present and relevant to us at this time, particularly those prayer points, praying for friends, our spiritual family within Sunshine Salvos. I invite you to join with me collectively as we lift our hearts and our prayers together in unity to the God who answers prayer. This morning, let us pray. Amen. Some announcements. We had a great day, as I mentioned just before, at Caroline Springs yesterday. The barbecue team was out in force, cooked up lots and lots of sausages and raised essential funds for who we are and how we serve our local community. It was a great day at Bunnings yesterday doing our sausage sizzle. I want to thank all of those faithful friends who took part, who gave their time and volunteered their service to ensuring that yesterday was a great success. We raised a very tidy sum of money. We haven't exactly confirmed how much that is, but certainly we know that it is a four-figure amount and it will be very, very helpful in the continuing of our welfare provision, our services at Sunshine Salvos. And we just keeping on and trying to do our best. I know we've got another Bunnings barbecue in October. We have to really continue to keep trying to raise as much money as we can so that we can effectively serve our local community in relevant and meaningful ways. Thank you to all who are involved. You know who you are. We love you and value you. And we'll see you back at the next barbecue. I have put up on the Facebook group page a new newsletter for the month of September. There are a few things coming up, of course, in September, and I think particularly of the first Saturday of September, September the 3rd, ladies, you have your spring pamper afternoon / evening to look forward to. Saturday the 3rd of September, ladies, 2 p.m. through to 7 p.m. Of course, you don't have to stay for all that time, but any time in that time frame, you can come in and get your pamper needs catered for. Haircuts, nails, threading, you name it. A simple fee of $20 per service, and you will be looked after by our wonderful team of beauticians and pampering experts at Sunshine Salvos. There'll be food and refreshments, drinks, all provided. But most of all, ladies, as you know, with those pamper events, the fun and the fellowship is really the draw and really the wonderful thing to look forward to. So that's this coming Saturday, the 3rd of September, ladies, between 2 and 7 at Sunshine Salvos, our spring pamper afternoon evening for you. Other announcements include things coming up in September. There will be a focus on the 25th of September, I think of, that will really center us in our Sunday worship on the theme of the International Day of Prayer for Victims of Human Trafficking. So that is certainly a worthy focus that I would invite you to be a part of, whether that's in our gathered worship or certainly here online. That's at the end of September, September the 25th. Through the rest of September, we're going to be finishing off our series on Esther. And also within that, there'll be, to let you know, Captain Fung and myself will be taking a week's break. But there'll still be lots of things going on at Sunshine Salvos, including vaccination hubs. We still really are wanting to encourage people in our community to get that fourth booster jab if they need it. So they will be happening at Sunshine Salvos. Look at the timetable on our Sunshine Salvos newsletter and you'll see the relevant days and times that vaccination hubs will be popping up at Sunshine Salvos through September. Check out the newsletter. Other relevant details are in there, including, of course, the September prayer list of people we want to lift up in prayer per week at Sunshine Salvos. And that's all the announcements I have for this day. As we look this day at the theme of patience, the beauty of patience, we would do well to look no further than the ultimate example and expression of patience within a human being, and that is found in the person of Jesus, who through his life exuded this wonderful, treasured gift of the Spirit in ways like no other. So patient in so many ways and on so many occasions when his patience must sorely have been tested. We're going to sing a song this day that really does in many ways speak to the heart of our faith, because whether it comes to patience or love or forgiveness or any of those fruits of the Spirit, we really do want to be like Jesus. And so when we think about patience today, let us also, when we sing this song, think about being like Jesus, having that hope within us, possessing us, that even in our thoughts and in our deeds and in our words, that we would aspire just simply to be like Jesus. Let's sing this wonderful prayer chorus this day. Amen. I haven't included a scripture time this day because I wanted to quickly just focus on three very short scriptures that will be a part of this message as we proceed through, and you will certainly appreciate that as we open our hearts and our minds this day to the living Word of God. May He speak to us, and may we receive from God this day that which we need for our lives, the story of our lives and the days ahead. I want you to think for a moment. Here we are on this day, 28th of August 2022. I want you to think for a moment, where were you exactly 10 years ago? Where were you on the 28th of August 2012? What was going on for you in your life? Were you living in the same place where you're living now? Were the people around you in your house the same people? Back in August 2012, were you working at the same place where you're working now? Did you have the same set of friends back then as what you do now? Perhaps back in August 2012, were you a part of the Sunshine Salvos faith community? Were you coming along to gathered worship services at Sunshine Salvos? Or perhaps were you a part of a different worshiping community? Where were you and what was happening in your life 10 years ago, back on August the 28th, 2012? My guess is that even in one decade, 10 years, your life and the things contained within it, as they are now, are far different than what they were 10 years ago. Because over the course of 10 years, this world has changed a lot. Our lives have changed a lot. Your circumstances, I'm sure, in many ways have changed a lot. And I make that point because we need to be mindful again just how many things do change within a span of time, especially when we talk about 10 years, a decade. Things change a lot. I mean, you think back to 10 years ago, how healthy were you? Were you in the same kind of health as what you are now? Were you looking the same? Did you have the same hairstyle? Did you have the same hair color? Things change and we change. The story of our life progresses, and over the course of 10 years, much happens. Not only within the world around us, but in our own worlds, within our households, within our lives, our friends, our family. Much changes over the course of 10 years. And I'm laboring that point because I want you to appreciate this morning the story of Esther in a different way, in a way that's not often focused on. Because when we come to the story of Esther and we have been looking at it in these past weeks, and if you got the book of Esther and you could probably read the whole story, even meaningfully, within 30 minutes. But what is not often reflected on and appreciated in terms of Esther and her story is that this is not a story that happened in 30 minutes. This is not a story that happened in a matter of weeks. This is a story that happened over the course of near enough to 10 years. And that doesn't get highlighted. And I'm going to show you three particular verses in Esther that simply remind us of dates. Now, if we read God's word and we read lots of stories, particularly from the Hebrew Bible, the Old Testament, dates are mentioned more than we would probably recognize or probably remember. Dates are stated quite a bit, and they're important because the Bible, outside of being the inspired word of God, is also historical documentation. Dates are mentioned. We're dealing with real people in real time, in real places, according to dates. And Esther is no different. And there are three dates I want to mention to you this morning that just show you the span of time that we really need to remember and consider regarding Esther's story, and particularly to appreciate them and to know and begin to see that Esther and her story is also a story about the beauty of patience. Let's start with this right at the very beginning of Esther. Esther chapter 1 verse 3. In the third year of the king, Xerxes deposes Queen Vashti and begins the process of seeking out a new queen in his third year of his reign. And then Esther comes into the story. And then if we jump to the next chapter, chapter 2, verse 16, we read, but in the seventh year of the king's reign, Esther is made queen of Persia. In the seventh year. Now you do the maths. In the third year, Xerxes got rid of the previous queen. His search for a new queen and the process of choosing a new queen took 4 years. Until in the seventh year, Esther is selected because the king loved Esther and she's made queen. 4 years Esther spent in a concubine being prepared for the potential of maybe becoming queen. And there were many other women in alongside Esther in the concubine being prepared for that maybe chance of becoming queen, and they never did. And we don't know what happened to them afterwards, but that's a significant period of time, 4 years, that Esther was taken into the king's harem and prepared for the potential, the chance of becoming queen, which of course she did become queen in the seventh year of Xerxes' reign. You don't think through that period of 4 years that Esther was kept within the king's harem, that she didn't have to exercise some patience. I bet she did. Let me share another verse with you. In the very next chapter, chapter 3 of Esther, we read that in the 12th year of King Xerxes, Haman institutes the plot to exterminate all the Jews in Persia. In the 12th year, that happened. So Esther is made queen in the 7th year of the king's reign. In the 12th year, the evil plot to wipe out the Jews of Persia is revealed. 5 years, Esther has been queen alongside King Xerxes. Can you see what I'm saying about time and how there is a span of time within this story that needs to be acknowledged and understood because it's relevant and because it shows within the unfolding story of Esther and particularly the persecution of the Jewish people that she isn't just sitting around dealing with this for a few days or a few weeks. This is years of time. Years of time where things are unfolding beyond her control. And even though you might think she's a queen, she's in a position of power, she's not really in a position of power as we might understand a queen or a monarch of today. Because she is subject to the king, who is ultimately powerful within his kingdom. And the queen is really a token position in that kingdom. Years are just flying by. Perhaps not flying for Esther, because she is patiently enduring this new life that she has alongside a king. but also beginning to understand, and with what I would imagine great stress and anxiety, begin to realize that there is such a terrible threat against her, her uncle, and her fellow Jews in Persia. And this isn't something that gets dealt with quickly. This is something that gets dealt with over time. And Esther shows in her qualities the beauty of patience. And it's really important that we consider that this morning. That's why I have labored on this point of time. Because to understand Esther and her story means that we must also understand that her story didn't take place within 5 minutes. It took place over a decade. Now, following the revelation of Haman's plot, things do begin to speed up, and there is an acceleration of the events that ultimately lead to the unveiling of this insidious plot, ultimately leading to the downfall or the prevailing of justice, as we looked at last week, in the fall and the death of Haman, and also proceeding through to the next parts of the story, which we're going to look at next week. Those events begin to snowball, and there is a shorter period of time, but we are still talking about months, potentially years, before we get to the very final part of the last chapter of Esther. Esther displays the beauty of patience in dealing with her circumstances over a vast period of time. And if you think back to where you were 10 years ago, and particularly to the things in your life that were challenging, how patient were you in dealing with them? Have there been some of those things that have stayed with you over the years? Have you been patient in dealing with them? Because being patient isn't easy. We all know that. And we live in a world that is not attuned to patience. I've read this quote before and I love it. It's one of my favorite quotes from Leo Tolstoy, famous Russian author. It's a quote about patience, and it goes something like this. Patience is waiting, not passively waiting. That is laziness. But to keep going when the going is hard and slow, that is patience. The two most powerful warriors are patience and time. I love that quote because it encourages us to be patient, but also reminds us that patience isn't just about sitting around and doing nothing. That's laziness. Patience is proactive. Patience is getting on with the business of life. Patience is enduring those tough times when things are testing us to the maximum and to our limits, but that we get on with things even when things are hard and slow. That's patience, moving forwards through the mire, a step at a time, one foot in front of the other. That's patience, proactively moving forwards through the tough times. And I love it that Tolstoy reminds us of that, and especially the idea that patience isn't just sitting around and waiting for something to happen. Patience is moving forwards to make things happen. And I think we see that through the story of Esther as well. We see that she moves forward in a measured way over a time period, strategically, along with Mordecai, ensuring the safety and salvation of her fellow Jews. It's a wonderful example of patience that we see in Esther that's really emphasized through her story. And I finish with this verse from Romans. It's a famous verse because it really inspires us from God's word to hold on to hope and hold on to be patient in those times in our life where we really do need to endure and be resilient. In Romans 8, verse 25, we read, "But if we hope for what we do not see. We eagerly wait for it with patience. My prayer for you in your life at this time, through whatever struggles and through whatever things that you are enduring through at this time, that you will remain patient, that you will hold on to the hope of God, that there will be a better tomorrow, that you won't just sit around doing nothing, waiting for something to happen for you, but that you will proactively meet the challenges in your life, moving forwards, step by step, with the Spirit of God empowering you and helping you. Being patient is a wonderful virtue. There is beauty in patience. And the beauty of patience, especially in a year like 2022, is that not many people have it. But I guarantee you, you know the people around you who are patient, and more than likely you value them and respect them because they are patient. May it be that you may also be considered and counted as one of those patient ones who people look to in and around your life as an example of godliness. May we all, with the Spirit's help, learn and develop and cultivate the fruit of patience within our own lives. May the Spirit help us to do that, we pray. In fact, let us do that now. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord, for the fruit of patience that your Spirit cultivates in and through our life. And we pray, Lord, that you would continue to help grow within us more patience to deal with the issues and the challenges of the story of our lives today. Lord, give us strength and endurance. Give us perspective. Give us wisdom. Give us resilience. Give us that something which seeks and strives never to give up. But Lord, we pray that you would continue the work of patience in and through and around our life. Lord, bless us in and through our journey and the story of our life. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I leave a prayer with you, a benediction, blessing this day. Now may the love of God the Father and the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Spirit of God be with you this week as patiently you keep in step with Jesus in the journey of your life. Amen. God bless you this week. May you have a great week. We're certainly going to be back here in this place next Sunday, a special Sunday, because it's Father's Day, where we will honour all the important men in our life, those men who have been influential, have been helpful, have been mentors, have been wonderful to us in our lives. We're going to honour men next Sunday, and we're going to do that through the story of Esther and just learning some manly lessons from Mordecai. Come here and join with us here in this same space next Sunday at 10 a.m. at Sunshine Salvos in this online space, or come even to our gathered worship. You're most welcome. In the meantime, have a great week and we will see you again soon. Bye for now.
Crowd.